What's going on, guys? Christian Belay here with the Denver Nosebleeds. As many of you know, Mikko Rantanen last night recorded his first 50-goal season of his career. He also got his 51st and 52nd goal in that game as well. In today's video, I wanted to talk a little bit about how Mikko Rantanen went from sliding in the loaded 2015 draft to becoming one of the best players out of that draft and one of the top 10 players in the NHL. So come along as we relive the short yet illustrious career so far of Mikko Rantanen. So when you look at Mikko Rantanen's pre-draft scouting, you can kind of see on the screen above, he was a very big duty, 6'4", 209, perfect for a power forward, and he was the number one European skater rated. But where Rantanen really shined was at the World Junior Championships with Team Finland. Mikko was a stud in this tournament, had a ton of goals, helped lead the Finns to a gold medal. He was the best player for Finland in this tournament. But there were still some concerns about Mikko Rantanen. He only had 9 goals and 19 assists in 56 appearances for the TPS Finnish hockey team. It was a young team, but Mikko still struggled a little bit. But that caused a lot of concern for scouts that he wasn't putting up the scoring production of a Connor McDavid. So that may be a reason why Mikko Rantanen fell in the draft. So we get to the 2015 draft, one of the greatest drafts in recent history. It gets kicked off with Connor McDavid, the best player in this draft. I think the Oilers nailed this pick. I don't really blame them for this pick. Connor McDavid's a pretty darn good hockey player. The Oilers absolutely nailed this pick with Connor McDavid. No one expected Mikko Rantanen to go first. Second overall was Jack Eichel. Say what you will about Jack Eichel, but when he's healthy, he's one of the best players in the NHL. The next picks were a little concerning to me. In my opinion, it was Dylan Strome, it was Mitch Marner, who's a darn good hockey player, and Noah Hanifin, which resulted in Mikko Rantanen falling all the way to number 10 for the Colorado Avalanche. A lot of people were expecting the Avs to take Lawson Crouse because of his big body and referenced how he was a Patrick Waugh prototype, but the Avs nailed it, taking Mikko Rantanen at number 10. The rookie years for Mikko Rantanen were interesting, to say the least. Mikko Rantanen never played on North American ice, so it was a little bit of an adjustment for him. Mikko would get a couple games with the Avs, only 9 of them. Mikko would then be reassigned to the San Antonio Rampage, and boy oh boy did Mikko figure out the AHL game quick. Mikko would play 52 games with the Rampage, which record 24 goals to go along with 36 assists for a grand total of 60 points total. Not too bad for a guy who hadn't played in North America before. Mikko Rantanen would go on to be an AHL All-Star, and he would go also on to win the AHL Rookie of the Year and set himself up for success going forward with the big club. Now, I know that Avs fans want to forget the 2016-2017 season because, boy oh boy, was it god-awful. But one of the lone bright spots for the Avs during that season was rookie Mikko Rantanen. Mikko Rantanen would go on to score his first hat-trick, as you see above, against Montreal. He would then go on to record a respectable 20 goals and 18 assists during his first NHL season. He would play in 75 games, but Mikko Rantanen was one of the few bright spots for an absolutely dreadful season, and it at least gave some Avs fans some hope that maybe this rookie would turn into a stud player. After a very strong rookie year for Mikko Rantanen, he was looking to grow his game even more in the 2017-2018 season. The Avalanche were a more competitive team, but everything changed for the Avs once Matt Duchene was traded to the Ottawa Senators. I don't know what happened to Mikko after that game, but Mikko simply exploded. Mikko would record a career high in goals with 29 and points with 84. Not only did Mikko Rantanen burst onto the scene, but one Nathan MacKinnon took the next step, and both of the young Avs superstars helped form one of the deadliest lines in the NHL with captain Gabe Landeskog on the other wing. The Avs would make the playoffs and take the Nashville Predators to 6 games, but would unfortunately bow out in the first round. But the future for the Avs was bright. In the 2018-2019 season, Mikko Rantanen would record another strong season with his first 30-goal season and another career high in points with 87. Mikko would help the Avs reach the playoffs again, as they even won a round against the Calgary Flames. The Avs would lose eventually in a controversial Game 7. I'm not still bitter about it, but Landy was on sides in that game. But the future for the Avs was even more bright, and many thought the Avs were the next great NHL dynasty. What would follow was a little bit of a contract dispute for Mikko Rantanen. He was a restricted free agent, and he would eventually sign a contract for 6 years at $9.25 million. What a bargain that is now. Miko would eventually help the Avs make the playoffs two more times, both times bowing out in the second round. But finally, last year in the 2021-2022 season, the Colorado Avalanche reached the summit. They beat the Tampa Bay Lightning in six games to win their third ever Stanley Cup championship, and Miko Rantanen was a huge part in that playoff run. I know he struggled a little bit in the playoffs in the St. Louis series and the Nashville series, but he really picked it up in the Edmonton series and was a huge factor in the Tampa Bay series. And Miko Rantanen finally was a Stanley Cup champion, and the Avs were finally Stanley Cup champions as well. So Miko Rantanen goes from 10th overall pick to a Stanley Cup champion. Not too bad of a draft pick if you ask me. So Miko Rantanen is a Stanley Cup champion. Going into this year, there were high aspirations that the Avs would repeat, but unfortunately for the Avs, this season has not gone according to plan, as the Avs have battled injury throughout the entire year, with captain Gabe Landeskog not playing in a single game and a ton of other star players for the Colorado Avalanche being injured. The one constant for the team this year, Miko Rantanen. Miko Rantanen scored his 50th, 51st, and 52nd goal last night against the San Jose Sharks to become the first 50-goal scorer for the Colorado Avalanche since Milan Hajduk did it all the way back 20 years ago in 2003. Very strange coincidence. It happened 20 years to the day, but Miko Rantanen joins the 50-goal club, an illustrious club to be a part of for Miko Rantanen as he continues his run to 100 points as well this year. Miko Rantanen has been this team's MVP all year long, as he has been the one constant player that has showed up game in and game out, and he is finally being rewarded for all of his hard work. Miko Rantanen is a 50-goal scorer and has helped lead the Avs to first place in the Central Division with a couple games left to play. Hell of a year from the guy from Finland as the number 10 overall pick. All right, guys, that's the end of the video. I hope you enjoyed looking back on the career of Miko Rantanen so far. But the biggest question a lot of people are still asking, myself included, is how did Miko Rantanen become one of the best players in the 2015 draft class? Obviously, Connor McDavid's number one, but you can make a strong case for Miko Rantanen being number two in this draft class. The biggest reason why Miko was able to accomplish this, in my opinion, is he was given time to develop in the AHL. The Avs did not rush him up to the NHL. He was given that time to hone his skills and become a strong two-way forward in the AHL, and it worked out for him. He ended up being the AHL Rookie of the Year, and when he came up to the Avs, he was set for success. So, in my opinion, Miko Rantanen is the second best player in this 2015 draft class, and congrats once again to Miko for hitting 50 goals for the first time in his career.